such an introduction. Reach sir, Sanjay sir, under such a beautiful voice, and also Raghav. I thank you, each and every person present here. Your gracious presence is so heartening to see and gives me immense courage to keep doing what I love to do. This novel, The Selfish Betrayals, is close to my heart, not just because it is my first novel, but also because this is dedicated to my two little ones whom I lost at different points of time. I would like to thank four people who gave me the confidence to write a novel. My mother, my father, my sister, and my wife. These four were the only people who knew that I am writing something. And when four or five elements of a universal set believe that the fifth one can do it, the fifth one is by default made to believe that he can do it. When I met some of you before this launch, this event, the most common question that was asked to me was, what was my inspiration behind this? So I will just summarize everything that I went through before and during writing this. In July, I was writing a script for Screenwriters Association Mumbai, of which I am a member. And it was a 2.5-page script. At the same time, my sister came up with a brilliant story for a college project. So I, taking some ideas from her story, I edited my script. And the result was a 3.5-page script. In August, I went through some personal loss. And that was the time when I decided that people, time, money, fame, everything will always come and go. But what remains forever is a book well written. So mid of August was when I started writing this novel. And this is basically a full grown tree, but the seed was that 3.5-page script. In January, I happened to listen Modi ji live when he inaugurated the National Museum of Indian Cinema in Mumbai. In his lecture, he mentioned that Bollywood movies help spread Indian culture to the world. Taking inspiration from that portion of his speech, I concluded that when a movie can spread the culture, then why can't a book? And a book will definitely spread it. That is why I tried to spread the culture, lifestyle, and the social divide that exists in Kanpur. Because that is where I was born, and I know much in detail about this. So around March, mid-March, I finished this novel. Copyright, publication, ISBN and all took some time. Today it is set for its launch. An interesting question was asked to me by my grandfather. He said, how is your novel different from others available in the market? Well, first of all, I'll say that there is an absolute zero probability that even the identical twins are perfectly alike. So two authors can never write a similar thing, or the same thing. Secondly, I have not taken any inspiration from any other author about his writing style or anything. Whatever I'm presenting is based on my research, my observation, and my style of writing. This is not anyone else's style. The manner in which I have painted pictures, or characters, events, backdrops, etc. are all what I have imagined, not anyone else. I also avoided the use of any offensive language or words in my novel, because this is for purposeful reading, not just for commercial reading. And the art of storytelling, which I learned through script writing, has enabled me to write a plot that flows like a meandering river, or like the lava coming out from the crater of a volcanic eruption. And my style of writing is not persuasive, what many authors try to do. I am just presenting some of the opinions which I think are right. Maybe they are my opinions. You might agree or you might not agree. But they are, that is what I am trying to say. You might like certain style of writing or you might not like certain style of writing. But that you will tell me whether you like my style or not after finishing my book. Lastly, I would also like to say a few words about the title of my novel, The Selfish Betrayals. I believe that all betrayals are not selfish. The selfish reasons why people betray others include love, hatred, money, helplessness and pain. All other betrayals are not selfish. In this book, I have written only about selfish betrayals. Other betrayals can include, for example, betrayal against humanity by attackers during the New Zealand mosque attack, or maybe the Pulwama attack. The attacker did not gain anything from that. That was a betrayal against humanity without any selfish motive. Or for that, another example, the Tej Bahadur incident, who was a soldier on duty for VFF. He posted a video on social media betraying his organization and going against the roots of the organization, saying, "I don't get proper food." That was also not a selfish betrayal. Later he got some political advantage through that. That was not his initial motive. Coming back to the title, The Selfish Betrayals, if you count, there are 19 letters, The Selfish Betrayals. And in this novel, there are exactly 19 betrayals explored. So hope you all have a great time reading it. Thank you. Jai Hind.